Hello everyone. Very nice to be here in this very beautiful city of Krachanov. I'm from the National Library of Vazov in Plovdiv, which is the second national repository of Bulgarian textual heritage, is the second biggest library in Bulgaria after the Sofia Library. The library has played an important role in the preservation of Bulgarian culture and history. It is the first cultural institution in southern Bulgaria, and it was established as a regional library and museum of Eastern Rumelia in 1879. After the unification, the established legislature regulated equal rights and obligations for the two national libraries in Sofia and in Plovdiv. That is why the National Library in Plovdiv has developed as an archive of Bulgarian books and periodicals, Bulgarian historical archive, a rich repository of manuscripts and revival literature, unique collections of rare and valuable publications. Today, National Library of Vazov in Plovdiv is a cultural institute that continues to dynamically enrich and develop the traditions of its prominent founders. Patrons annually realize over 120,000 visits and own approximately 300,000 library documents. The library's holdings are comprehensive and amount to over 1,900,000 library units from various fields, from science fiction, manuscripts, old printed, rare, valuable publications. Bulgarian and foreign periodicals, photographs, maps, audiovisual and electronic documents, original works of art, and personal libraries. The library traditionally follows and implements the latest trends in automation. 1979 is the year of the introduction of the library's first computer system, IZOT 0310, which is a Bulgarian main computer system, and information search devices. And in 1980 was the first subscription to the AGRIS file database, which is an agricultural international database. This was done in 1980. A local library information network was established in 1994, and in 2008 was the year of the founding of the digitization center where I work. Since then, the library has participated in various projects on the national and international level concerning the digitization and online display of its valuable holdings. Some noteworthy projects are Europeana Photography, Embark, BG08 Digital Culture and Historical Heritage of Plovdiv Municipality, and others. One of our oldest collections is located in Nalis Repositorium, where digital copies of 95 Slavonic manuscripts from the 12th to the 18th century can be viewed. Nalis Repositorium is a prestigious academic digital library founded by the Central Library of the Bulgarian Academy of Science, Sofia University, St. Clement Ohridsky, and the American University in Bulgaria. This is an example of a manuscript page as it is displayed in Nalis Repositorium. A very important project for the library was the Digital Cultural and Historical Heritage Project of Plovdiv Municipality, which project aimed to digitize the movable and immovable cultural and historical heritage from the territory of Plovdiv Municipality, from the collections of the region's foremost cultural institutions. These are our library, National Library in Vazov, the Regional Museum of History, the Regional Ethnographic Museum, the Regional Archaeological Museum, the Old Plovdiv Institute, and the City Art Gallery. And within the project, National Library of Vazov received valuable new equipment such as scanners, DSLR camera, powerful computer. And the project, it ran from 2015 until 2017. As a result of the project, an online portal was created at The address of the portal is digital.plovdiv.bg. This portal displays the digitized holdings of the participating institutions. We made the decision to develop our part of this portal and to make it our own digital library so that we can have a single place where we can display all our digital content. In 2017, the digital library became available online at the same address, digital.plovdiv.bg, as part of the portal. So far, we have available 9 collections, books, of which currently there are 193, which are predominantly statues of professional organizations from Plovdiv and the region, from the end of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century, which are of great interest to researchers because they provide insight into the way of life of the era after the liberation. And the plans are to continue uploading the most valuable and compelling holdings of the library, such as rare books and valuable materials. The other collection is Periodical Publications, which is a collection of newspapers and magazines currently containing 216 full text titles with approximately 20,000 separate issues. Particularly valuable are the newspapers and magazines from the East Romanian period, which are Marica newspaper, which was the first Bulgarian newspaper which was printed in Bulgarian and in Bulgarian language. After the liberation, Narodni glas, Nauka, Zura, and many other important newspapers, as well as other revival period magazines and others. In manuscript collection is currently there are 16 manuscripts displayed there. We plan to add more, but since we have in our repository a very big collection, there are 95 altogether manuscripts, and most of the scientific community which are interested in manuscripts can already know this digital library. So in our digital library we are not so much pressed to present more manuscripts, but we will continue to add all of them. Graphic Publications is a collection of art prints, lithographs, etchings, engravings, posters, original paintings. Especially interesting are the projects for monumental works, of which there are a total of 95 at the moment, which are mostly large-scale wall murals, frescoes, ceramic tile work, most of them realized in many Bulgarian towns. The projects were created by renowned Bulgarian artists such as Dimitar Kirov, Ioan Leviev, and Chupirokov, and others. This is an example of such projects for monumental works. Another interesting collection is the Cartographic Publications, which presents valuable possessions of the library, such as the oldest map of Bulgaria, which was created by a Bulgarian and printed in Bulgarian language, which is the map of the present Bulgaria, Thrace, Macedonia and the adjacent lands from 1843, which was the same year as the previous presenter also mentioned, the same year, 1843. The collection of photographs is it will be developed in the future. The library has approximately 4,000 photographs altogether, quite a large collection. Currently, only 10 of them can be seen at the digital library, but we plan to increase this collection to make it bigger. The archives digital collection also will be developed in the future. The Bulgarian historical archives in the National Library are of nationwide value, because they review key moments of the political, economic and cultural development of Bulgaria. The documents cover the period from the 12th to the 20th centuries, with the most numerous being from the second half of the 19th century. In the audiovisual documents collection, also there are some movies from the opening of the new building of the library and other interesting things which can be seen. In 2019, a new functionality was introduced in the digital library of National Library of Vazov, indexing and searching in PDF files text contents. The machine encoded text is obtained through the use of optical character recognition, or so-called OCR software. By including the OCR step, full text indexing and internal document search capability. Bless you. By including the OCR step, full text indexing and internal document search capability can be applied, making it easier for users to discover and use the materials. If the PDF files are digital born, then there's no need, of course, to do OCR. The main activities within the scope of the new functionality are as follows. The first step was the development of the software platform of our digital library so that we can upload and display PDF files with the possibility to search the contents of the file. The second step was the purchasing of OCR software, which in our case is RB Fine Reader 14, which is one of the most widely used software products for OCR processing of PDF files. And another step that we have envisioned is a one-time migration service for all existing collections in the digital library in order to replace the existing image files in the platform with the corresponding new OCR PDF files. Because the manual work to do so will be very long, and we believe that such migration will be a better practice. The updated capabilities of the software platform required changes in the user interface in order to accommodate the new functionalities. New search fields were added and content searches applied to both global and collection search. Searching is done in the indexed contents of the PDF files and provided metadata, and is augmented by the Boolean operators which are supported by the platform of the digital library, which is SharePoint 2010, powered by Microsoft. A new gallery tool was also necessary for viewing and navigating PDF files, which has most of the necessary capabilities, such as searching by keyword in the contents of the file, marking the matches from the distinctive color, displaying the numbers of the matches, and provide controls to move from match to match. Suitable navigations of the pages of the documents with instruments such as thumbnail view of the individual pages and the blank field where a desired page number may be entered manually. Full screen view, help menu with additional tools to navigate to the first or last page of the file to change the orientation, landscape or portrait. Also a hand tool with which to move the image around. Some of the specifics of OCR and PDF file processing, which we, the way we do it, is that we use our primary master files, so-called master files, which are stored on the library servers and created for the purposes of long-term digital storage. We found that this is the best practice because the master files are 24-bit color images scanned predominantly at 300 ppi from the original paper source. And generally, scanning from the originals is acknowledged to produce higher quality images. And in this way, the degree of recognition will be approaching its maximum. The master files will be processed to a single PDF file for each unit of cultural heritage. For example, a single PDF file should be a monograph, a book, or a newspaper issue, for instance. The resultant file will have appropriately lowered image quality with a size suitable for online display. The PDF will have its images aligned with the hidden machine readable text. The actual text will be underneath the image, hidden. The text which was product of the recognition. MRC compression method will not be used. We have decided not to use MRC compression. MRC compression, maybe most of you know that the actual text is machine readable, it's visible, but the background, all the colors and all that has not been recognized as text by the OCR software is very low quality, and the aim is to achieve a very low size of the image, but we prefer to display our holdings in the best way possible, so that's why we chose not to use MRC compression. After a thorough review of the available software, which included sampling the experience and opinions of libraries from Bulgaria, Russia, Ukraine, Serbia, and other countries where the recognition of Cyrillic text is a special relevance, it was decided to purchase a licensed version of ABBYY Fine Reader 14, which was the most widely used software to perform OCR and in our test was the best at recognizing Cyrillic text. Other options were considered as well, such as Adobe Acrobat 11 Pro, but the results achieved were not as satisfactory. Using Fine Reader 14 on master files obtained from well-preserved originals written in modern Bulgarian language yields very high OCR success rate, most often above 99%. However, texts that have that we have to deal with and those of very high cultural and historical value and with expired copyright, of course, are predominantly from the period before the orthographic reform of 1945. This was a reform of the spelling of the Bulgarian language when the language that we know nowadays is after this year, 1945. Sorry? The accuracy of OCR software is language dependent and many of the old alphabetic letters, the old grammar, the old street words, phrases, multilingual documents, they pose a serious problem for OCR programs. At the same time, despite the care that has been taken by the library to preserve the originals, all textual documents present challenges to OCR, such as the natural darkening of the paper, the faded print, the in-library binding in proximity to the text, etc. There are a number of ways to improve the accuracy of the recognized texts. A straightforward solution is to include the post-OCR manual corrections as another stage to the digitization process. Considering the large amount of time necessary to achieve high levels of accuracy, around 98%, the labor-intensive cleaning required to remove OCR errors often means this process may be no more efficient than manually inputting text from scratch. A way to mitigate this issue while still using manual labor is to design the digital library software platform in such a way that it uses crowdsourcing and involves the users to of the resources to make corrections themselves. This solution was first implemented by the National Library of Australia in their newspaper digital collection in the Trove Library, and in Australia it's considered a successful practice. Also in Finland, I know they made this. Another method of improving the quality of OCR relevant to the software ABBY Fine Reader is the option to train the program to patterns the interpretation of which the software deems uncertain. This is useful in cases of non-standard fonts and is especially important for older Cyrillic texts where the training to recognize specific letter symbols is essential. Such are the letters Yat, Ulamius, Malakius, etc., which were gradually removed from the modern language and eventually reducing the number of the alphabet to 30 letters. In ABBY Fine Reader, it is also necessary to create a new language set which includes these old symbols so that they can be represented in the text. When reviewing the practices of libraries in Bulgaria, which offer recognized text in their digital libraries, it is evident that there is no uniform standard for the ways in which OCR of texts before the orthographic reform of 1945 is performed. For instance, some of the reviewed libraries were tempted to replace the archaic old letter symbols with their modern equivalents, which is done in order to aid the search of the context of older texts, so that users would not have to write the required search expressions twice, in the old and in the new spelling. This is okay, but I personally think that in this way the loss of information is inevitable, because the spelling conversion is not fixed in the sense that old letter symbols are often replaced by more than one modern letter symbol. For instance, the letter Yat may be represented by the modern E or Ya, or the Goremiat Yus may be represented by modern E, A, sometimes U or E. So during the OCR steps, if we decide to replace these symbols, we have to fix one of these letters, which is in a way wrong. We are currently participating in the project CLADA-BG, and the mission of this project is to establish a national technological infrastructure for language, culture and historic heritage resources and technologies, which to provide public access to language resources and tools for Bulgarian language processing and for access and management of data sets for various societal tasks targeted at a wide audience. The project includes partners from the scientific field as well as from the cultural field, and last week there was a meeting in Sofia and there were some interesting ideas and presentations there. As a conclusion, I would say the new file format will lead changes to the work cycle of the Digital Center, which in terms of web presentation focused exclusively on the JPEG image format. An important part of the future digitalization work will be the mastery and long-term establishment of OCR-related activities, aiming to ensure the highest possible level of resource usability. Therefore, it is important to share digitalization experience with other partners working in the same field with the form a comprehensive strategy and collaborative solutions. Involvement in developing tools to automate the submission of data to Ghana and other digital libraries is a top priority as well. And a stronger presence there is mandatory, but the great amount of manual work that we currently have to do deserves our potential to contribute in a meaningful and visible way. But we have hope that in the future and with our partners will be able to achieve more. Thank you very much.